Hello, I'm Robert from the Dr. Bubble channel on YouTube. How are you? Now in this particular video, I'm going to show you how to make a fake engine plume inside After Effects. Like many other software packages, there's plenty of ways to skin a cat, and After Effects is no different. Now, I've got a render, which is just a basic render, with an alpha channel at the back. And what we're going to do is make or create a engine plume at the back here. Now the final shot or composite can be found here. This is done by using Andrew Kramer's optical flares. Now I'm going to show you this way, and I'm going to show you a way of making it with solids as well. So if you haven't got that package, then don't fear. It's a simple way of achieving this effect. The only difference is that this way, the optical flares way, it's a more or less a couple clicks and you've achieved your effect, whereas the solid way is a longer, more of a laborious way of doing things, but if you've got the time, you'll get a greater looking effect. Now let's just start the actual tutorial. So let's start. Let's put the unfinished composite into its own composition, and first things first, just slightly change the brightness of this image so I can see what I'm doing. Just there, do. In addition, if you can hold down Control and press Y, you'll produce a solid. Just press on that. We'll use this as the optical flare layer, and we go down to optical flares. Go down to the mode, and naturally you can do add or screen. You can use those; they're generally the best ones to use for this purpose. Go to options on optical flare. Going to clear all, and choose the glow. And also, you can add a spike ball, which is a nice one as well. And you can reduce the scale to about 40. Okay. Let's put down the brightness there. And we change the colour to a more predictable thruster colour. Remember, this is sci-fi, so you don't have to do the predictable colour like I've just done. You could do anything you like, because obviously sci-fi can be what it likes anytime it likes to be. So, next up is to use a liquify, which is in distort. Very useful tool, this one. It's kind of a brush that smears and pushes pixels about. If you just adjust some of the parameters, there we go, to 35. Now, what we can do is just kind of push some of the white and orange in this image into what we want. Let's just push it here. Now we can push it, let's see, around this angle. Now imagine I'm only taking, I'm not going to take very long to do this, because obviously I'm under a time constraint. You can make it look as beautiful as possible. But again, it's just demonstrating what you can do with this effect. I mean, I've got a better effect with the actual solids, which will be in part two. So watch out for that. Let's push this back in. I can meld this in as well. A spinning after effect, no pun there, of course. Okay. I mean, also you can also color correct the actual optical flares layer, which I'll do quickly. Okay. So that's just how long's that taken me? That's 3 minutes work. Looks pretty crude, but it doesn't look too bad. In addition, you can also copy and press Control V and make it more intenser, and you can turn this down, or the opacity down, to about 50. Then change some of the colours perhaps to a red. You can flick this on and off. There we go. Give more of an intenser thing. You can also scale this up as well. You can make it smaller or larger or brighter. Okay. Good thing is you can add an additional, perhaps we can use a vector blur in this one. So basically the layer consists of optical flares, liquify, curves and vector blur. Now on the layer on top, which is the red layer, which is producing these red effects, we can do this. Let's go to constant length and we'll put the jack up the actual amount, and you can see it spins, and if I turn that on and off, you can see what that does. It uses a nice hue on top. If you do it outwards, you'll get this effect. It all depends what you're going for, but it's just the application and what can be done, and with using optical flares. I mean, we have got a lens flare incorporated into the actual set, which is called lens flare there, but it's only got three lens flares and it's got nowhere near the parameters that you can adjust in optical flares. I mean, you have all these and custom, and you've also got presets as well. So sometimes it's good to make your own flares like this, because you can come to a stage where you just use presets and doesn't look very original whatsoever. So there's one way you can produce a thruster, in this case probably an unconvincing thruster, but like I said, only I've used up a 4 or 5 minutes in explaining this technique. Again, it's just a technique and nothing set in stone, but once you get used to using liquify, which is a really intuitive tool, and vector blur and other bits and pieces inside After Effects, then the sky's the limit, and you can add all sorts of pleasant effects and interesting effects to your compositions, and make them look really unique. Because there's no law of the land in After Effects, you can do what you like within reason, especially with sci-fi. Anyway, part two is going to be using solids, which is going to be that will produce a different effect altogether. But more or less, it's going to be a thruster plume, and I might use some thruster plumes down here and on the wings as well, just to demonstrate the solid application, or using the solids as a basis of use, you know, as a thruster plume. Anyway, that said, hopefully you've got something out of this. You can take what you can. It's good to know what other people are doing to achieve their effects. In the meantime, have a good day or good evening, and check out part two when it comes. Goodbye.